So, I have a mix of things on my desk here. We're going to do Marta's Fag Supply Challenge. It's quite an old one. I will pop it in the description so you can see which video it is I'm going for with this one. But we've got some papers. I'm going to use my modelling paste because I have it. She creates her own with acrylic paint, but I'm not going to do that. Acrylic paint instead of gesso this time. So that doesn't count as a supply, that's just a staple. I've got some pigment powder. She uses eyeshadows, but I don't have any old eyeshadows. I recently went through those, although this one here, this greenish colour, I can't really get it out, it's a bit tight in there, but that's an eyeshadow. I have tea, my markers. So what have we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah. So, let's clear some of this away. And grab, I just need another staple item. That's my glue. Should I just use grit stick? Glue stick? Yeah, let's do that. I think that's what she did in the video. So I don't want my page to look exactly like Marta's, but who knows? It'll probably look pretty similar. That and music paper. Let's use this scrappy bit that's been on the desk for ages. So, just letting my computer warm up takes a very long time for it to wake up. Quite old, very slow. Just need to edit my August mission inspiration. So I'm just gonna do this whilst I'm waiting for that to do its thing. You can probably hear it in the background. Too long so that my computer can handle the editing of it. So I'll do it as quickly as possible. And we'll add some white acrylic. Not on that piece, did I? It's a boring piece. way. Now then. So that's that. And then let's get a bit of glue under there. Okay. And then acrylic. And I need a brush. It's quite a soft brush, so. Just a bit more. Okay, so I'm going to let that dry. Trim off the edges. And then we'll put some texture on, I think. Okay, so I have this cardboard stencil that I made a while ago that I'm going to use with my paste. If this is still good, I haven't used it for a while. Let's have a look. Dry at the top. Oh dear. Okay, let's see. Let us see. Probably should use palette pad. Use up this, I think, because it's getting a bit weird. So, alright, so that's that side. Ooh, that came out really well actually. Put that down a second. Move that over so that I can pop the stencil down. I've replaced it a little bit. more out. Yes. Okay. Yes. The edges of my paper, but that's okay. Do that a bit. Just want to separate the pages because the paste has gone over the edge. There we go. So we'll leave that to dry now that my computer is ready to go, and I'll be back in a sec. Okay, so let's see how we go with this. I've got my book here and my markers. Let me just go out just a little bit so you can see a bit more. Okay, so I'm going to try this. I've got no idea how this is going to work. I'm going to pop some of the pigment down on the tin, because I don't really want to do what Marta does and dip my pens into the tea, because I don't want to ruin my markers. So I'm going to use the tea. Pick up the pigment. Just sort of play with it that way. Just on this side. Okay, what other colour? Should we try a blue? A darker blue. Let's see if that comes out. Kind of greenish as well. Probably will, yes, obviously. It's quite dark. Can't see it, I know, sorry. Let's go for this side. Let's go the opposite corner. Blue. kind of greyish colour. I just want to dry that off just a little bit before we add any more colour. Okay, so it's a little bit dry. I'm just going to add some of the tea on its own now. Bit of a spray because it's forming lines. Too many lines, and I want it to be a bit more fluid. Another quick dry. Okay, so I'm going to pop some more of the pigment down again. Just cleaned up the mess that was on there. Still a bit wet because of the baby wipes. So. So I'm going to go with the same colours, the blue and the teal. And again, a spray. And same to this side. Okay, we move forward with the blue down at the bottom. Teal in the middle. And a little spray. Liking it. Okay, and then dry. Just move that out of the way. All I'm going to add now is just splashes of tea and pen and whatever else is on the brush. And then we will try again. Okay, and now we need to do our heart shape. So shave it down a little bit. Still too big? Yeah. Maybe a little bit less here. That's not bad. I noticed there was a splash on the lens then. Still a bit there, but I'll do it in a minute. Okay. Just going to pop that out of the way for 1 second. I can find a clear surface. Let's have the palette pad back. Got the palette paper. Some acrylic. Now I need to struggle and get this out of here. Okay, so I'm going to use the steel. Just tip them out. that's actually coming out really nice. Let that dry. I need to find now a focal point or something. She had a butterfly on there. May use a butterfly myself, and I need to find a nice couple of words to go on the page. Okay, so I've decided I want to add a little bit of a darker edge to everything. So I'm going to start with my brown pen. I'm going to use the tea again. I don't know what that noise is. I think it's some alarm next door, so sorry about that. I'm just going to go around the edge. Of my heart. So we'll put that on the side to dry again. Grab the book. And do the same thing to the page. It's just a different way to edge the page, I suppose. Still keeps it in that vintagey brownish tone. That's a nice little bit of darkness, but not too much. Let's have a little bit more. And then let's add some brown tea just to soften it into the middle a little bit. Okay. There we are, I like that. Now, move that out of the way again. Yes. So, I'm going to add some Elmer's glue, I think. Sorry, that noise is so distracting. This is still wet, so it might not stay. But we will see. I'm not going to raise mine up like Remy did with cardboard behind it, but I like that. Now, let's see, do we have a butterfly in here that will match? I'm just going to have a look through this slot and I'll be right back. Okay. Yes, this one. So these are, this one is from Remy's digital downloads, the ones that you have to pay for, the Collectiona, that one. Okay, the battery's running out. Will it last? Don't know. And I've got my sentiment. Oh, no, I do want to put that on some paper, so I'm probably going to charge the battery. Just bear with me a sec. Okay, so quickly stick it to this cream card. Should have used the spirit glue for this one. So it's just paper to paper, but never mind. Okay, just quickly plugged her into the computer to charge a little bit. Now then, so I'm going to cut around with a border. Just bit the bullet and did it. Printed a load off and just did it. Okay, so we are going to grab some glue onto there. Might need a lot of glue because of the texture. Yep. So, let's stick with the same brown. Perhaps I should have used a extra old glue or gel medium or something. I'm going to go lightly around the heart. Butterfly. Not that it needs it much because it's a dark colour on a very light background, so it stands out nicely. But this will just cover up any white edges that I missed when I was cutting, I suppose. That's dry enough. I'm just gonna do this quickly, and then I think I'm gonna go downstairs out of the way of that maddening noise because it's still going off. Ah, look, too hasty. So it's popping up a little bit here, but I'm gonna let it be. I think it's okay. Oh, straight into the glue again. Oh, here we go. There we go. And then I have my date stamp. Today is the 31st of August, last day of August. This year is going past frighteningly quick. I'm going to use Vintage Photo. Put the right way up. Okay, and then stamp. There we go. So this to me, I'm just going to glue the paper back down to the page there because it's coming away. Thanks to all the moisture. I'm going to leave that bit sticking up there. I like that bit. anyway, so this to me is a very martyr page. It's not necessarily something that I would have created on my own, but I do like it, but it's got a very martyr feel about it, so yeah. So please do hop over to her video, I will share it below so you can see. She does hers a bit differently to mine, and it comes out more reddish and orangish because of the things that she uses. I used mainly greens and blues because of that turquoisey eyeshadow I knew that I had. So I was trying to stick in that kind of colour house. I know, it looks really nice. I really like that. I love the way the tea has made it. I don't know how to explain it. It's like a, not dirty exactly, but definitely distressed and muted, and yeah, I like that. So I may have to use that technique a bit more often. Yeah, I love the splashes as well. Okay, so I'm going to leave you with that, charge that up, make sure that that video finishes editing. My computer's doing well so far, no blue screens as of yet. I'm still waiting. But yeah, thank you for watching, and I will see you again soon. Bye.